Hello everyone, this is Ed Unit. In this tutorial, we are going to learn about the op-amp and the circuits possible with it. So op-amp is in short for operational amplifier. It gets its name because it is used for performing mathematical and logical operations in circuits. So this is a symbol of a basic op-amp. So you can see, unlike normal amplifying circuits, we have two input ports. And we give input either at least on only one port or on both ports. So what we get is the amplified version of the difference between these two ports. If the voltage difference between these two ports is Vd, then Vd equal to V1 minus V2, then we get an output voltage which is proportional to the voltage difference, that is V1 minus V2. So we can be written as a voltage gain multiplied by the voltage difference. This voltage gain is a ratio of output voltage by input voltage, which is available to us. So now moving on to the basic characteristics. This is the characteristics of an ideal op-amp. So in practical cases, we do not get exact condition, but close to them. So first, it is the infinite open loop voltage gain. And the second one, the infinite input impedance. The third one, the zero output impedance. And finally, infinite bandwidth. Infinite bandwidth because it should be able to amplify the signals at any frequency range. So it should have infinite bandwidth in ideal cases. So in practical cases, the infinite becomes high and zero becomes very low. So high open loop gain input impedance and bandwidth and very low output impedance is the characteristics of our op-amp. This tutorial we are going to take a look at the four basic and simplest circuits using op-amps. So they are the inverting amplifier, the non-inverting amplifier, the summing amplifier and the difference amplifier. So without wasting time, let's move on to the first one. So in the inverting amplifier, we know that there is 180 degree phase shift between the input and output voltage. That is why it is called an inverting amplifier. So we have to apply the input at the negative terminal so that we get an inverted output. Negative terminal is also known as the inverting terminal. So we give an input voltage Vi and the non-inverting terminal is grounded. So we have to get an output which is inverted form of the input. But as you know, an ideal op-amp has high open loop gain. So if we give a small voltage, it would produce infinity voltage at its output. So it is in ideal cases, it goes to saturation. So we have to limit it and bring it down from saturation so we can observe the waveform. So we give a negative feedback like this, which limits the voltage available at the input so that we get the required waveforms as the output. So now we have to analyze the circuit. So before going into analysis, you have to know two basic assumptions that we take. The assumptions are, first one is virtual short, which means the two input terminals are at the same potential. That is, if this point is V1, then this point is also V1. And the second assumption is that zero current is drawn by both ports of the op-amp. So if this is I1 and this is I2, both I1 and I2 equal to zero. So these are the two assumptions that we take throughout the analysis of all op-amp circuits. So suppose I1 current flows through R1 and I2 current flows through RF. Now we know that this current that I already marked, I1, is zero. So I1 is equal to I2. Now I1 is given by the voltage difference divided by the resistance. As this terminal is at zero potential and applying virtual short, this point is also at zero potential. So the voltage difference is Vi minus zero by the resistance, that is R1. And similarly, the current I2 is zero and VO are the two voltages at two ends of the resistor RF. Now zero minus VO by resistance RF would be the current flowing through RF. Now we know that these two currents should be equal to each other. That is, we get Vi by Ri or R1 equal to minus VO by RF, which gives us with the relation VO divided by Vi, output voltage by input voltage, it is a gain, voltage gain, equals minus RF by Ri. So this is the voltage gain of an inverting amplifier. So now let's move on to the non-inverting amplifier. So non-inverting, as the name suggests, the output is the amplified form of the input, but should be in the same phase, that is 0° phase shift should appear. So we would give the input at the positive or non-inverting terminal. So we just shift this voltage into the non-inverting terminal and the other part of the circuit remains same. We again give the feedback so that we do not go into saturation. So again we are going to take the two assumptions, that is virtual short and zero current principles. So zero current flows through this path and this path, and the two terminals should be at the same potential as that of the positive terminal or the non-inverting terminal. So this point would get a potential V1. Now this branch, this path starting from the ground and then R1, RF and ending at V0 and then to the ground can be considered as a loop, as these two are the same point or at zero potential. So I redraw this loop into such a form and you can see that the voltage at this point is V1. So V1 is the voltage across the resistor Ri or R1. Now applying voltage divider rule, we can obtain V1 directly as R1 by Rm plus RF times the total voltage V0. So therefore V0 by V1, which is our voltage gain of the non-inverting amplifier, would be R1 plus RF by R1, which can be rewritten as 1 plus RF by R1, which is the voltage gain of our non-inverting amplifier. So if we give an regular input like this, we would get amplified input in the same phase. Amplification would be 1 plus RF by R1. Next step is the summing amplifier. Summing amplifier, as the name suggests, it adds up the input voltages and provides that at the output. So we here I am taking the inverting summing amplifier. You can also redraw it with in the non-inverting terminal so that we get a non-inverting summing amplifier. So here the inverting summing amplifier, we give the three or multiple inputs at the inverting terminal. VB, RB, VC. So we gave three input voltages VA, VBB and VC at the inverting terminal, and the non-inverting terminal is grounded as usual. And here we would give a feedback so as to avoid saturation. Now we have to apply the two assumptions, that is the current through this branch and this branch is zero, and these two points are at the same potential. So here, as it is a 0 volt or ground, at this point we would get 0 volt potential. Now, like as in the inverting amplifier, we would have to add the current I1 coming to this branch and the current I2 in this branch. So here I1 is given by the summation of the current through these three branches, that is VA minus 0 by RA plus VB minus 0 by RB plus VC minus 0 by RC. Now, like in the previous case, we will get the value of the current I2 as the voltage difference, that is 0 minus VO by resistance RF. Now we have to equate these two terms, which gives minus VO by RF is equal to VA by RA plus VB by RB plus VC by RC. So now for getting the exact sum, we have to take the value of the resistors so that we get VO equals to the sum. So if RF equal to R1 equal to sorry if RF equal to RA equal to RB equal to RC equal to R, our whole denominator cancels off, right? So we get the numerator only, that is VO equal to minus VA plus VB plus VC. Actually, we are giving a unity gain so that we get the exact sum of the input. So this is our summing amplifier. So now moving on to the final circuit of this module, the difference amplifier. Here in difference amplifier, we give the two inputs at the two ports so that like the normal property of an op amp, we get the difference at the output with an amplification. So we take the gain as unity, we get the exact difference between the two voltages. So I'm giving the two inputs. Now this is, they let it be V1, and here let it be V2. And as usual, we would give a feedback resistor RF, and sometimes they would also give a compensation resistor due to compensate for other external errors. Now this is our circuit, and if for unity gain we are taking all resistances are as equal to R, which is a common value. Now as all the resistors are equal, we get unity gain. Therefore, V output is given by V1 minus V2, or the difference between the two voltages with the non-inverting terminal V1 and inverting terminal V2. So this is our difference amplifier. So these are the first four circuits using op amps. Now in the next video, I'll be doing other circuits like the integrator, differentiator, logarithmic, etc. So stay tuned and subscribe my channel. Thank you.